All right, Saggies, your turn. Let's look ahead to April. What is going on for you? This is a monthly reading for Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Let's see where we go. If you're looking for the North Node readings, that was last week. So there's a, I'll put a little link to the playlist. Those are 3-month forecasts. So if you want to get the Sagittarius North Node forecast, you can take a look at that, the spring forecast, Sun, Rising, and North Node. There's the link. Also, if you're wanting to jump on to our spiritual business class, that is happening this month in April. Very excited for that. We're going to help you get rolling on something that's going to bring you some independence and some stability, financial stability for yourself. I'm very passionate about that. So if you want to jump on to the spiritual business class, link is below. Okay. Let's see where we go. Ah, I saw this bluebird today, the bluebird of happiness. Oh, beautiful. Spirit Garden of Winter Retreat. What do you say about that, Charlie? Hey, Charlie. He's not looking at me at all. And the wise woman of the grove, Grace. Hi, Charlie. Okay, so let's see where we go from here. I feel like some of you are really trying to figure out what was going to bring you happiness. I think for some of you, it's going to be a lot. It's going to be about less, you know, maybe subtracting rather than adding. Some of you are going to find peace in nature, doing more things in nature. I know I'm a Sag, sun sign, and I'm really getting drawn to more gardening and working with the Bach flower essences and working with tinctures and everything like that. I'm really feeling drawn to that. So there's something about earth medicine, very Native American kind of expression. I'll read you the wise woman of the grove in a minute, okay? Maybe in the extended. There's another wise woman of the grove, the Empress, out in nature, beautiful. All right, the Page of Swords, the Magician, the Nine of Swords, Seven of Swords, Eight of Cups, the Knight of Wands. There's Sag energy right there. Page of Cups, Seven of Wands. Oh boy, this is interesting, isn't it? Nine of Wands. Look at this. So 9, 9, 7, 7, 7, 8, 9. That's a progression. We also have two pages, which is about messages. And Magician is ruled by Mercury, which is also about messages. So some of you could be starting to receive more messages, maybe spiritually. Okay, the Page of Swords and the Magician. All right, I'm manifesting something new coming in my life. I'm manifesting love. I'm manifesting this kind of earthy springtime. This is actually summertime, I feel like. Yeah, this is actually summertime. But I'm wanting to embrace something new in my life. And yet there's this mindset that I can't have it or that I'm not really doing the right thing. So I see this sense of like, wow, I know what I want to create. I know where I want to go, but then I retreat. Okay. Then I pull back because my mindset is still not quite right. So we'll explore that. And I feel like you're your own worst enemy right now, Sag. You might be battling against yourself in some way. And you do have this new path to walk here, the Eight of Cups and the Knight of Wands. You might have to leave something behind. Maybe this idea of freedom that you have has been keeping you from the love that you want or keeping you from manifesting what you want. Like, I want to have this amazing love affair, amazing life partner, but I'm afraid of commitment. Or I'm wanting to have, you know, I'm wanting to do things in my career and yet I need to go and get a new degree or something like that. So I'm like, no, I don't want that. Anything that's too much structure, I think, is sending you down a road, Sagittarius, that might be antithetical to what you're wanting to create. So there needs to be a balance here. And I just feel like the Seven of Wands is kind of resistance. The Seven of Swords is like sneaking away or not. There's a sense here of like, yeah, I want what I want. I want to be the Empress, but I might not want to do the work or the effort. Or I might have this sense in my head that I'm not worthy of it in some way. And I feel like that is like a never-ending cycle. So we're really working with a cycle that does need to go away. Nine of Swords. Chariot. I want to move forward quickly. There's the Eight of Swords, the Two of Cups, and the Knight of Cups. There's some real fear and trepidation. What you're wanting most is the thing you're also most afraid of. Okay, what you're wanting most, what have I done to my hair? What you're wanting most is also the thing you're most afraid of. And I feel like that's taking you off course because you're doing the manifesting work here, but then it gets derailed because you don't really see that your own belief isn't in alignment with what you want. Okay, and so you keep wondering, why am I not progressing? Why am I not getting what I want? Well, you're not really in alignment with that. The mindset is not. Five of Wands, Five of Swords, Strength, and the Knight of Pentacles. Okay, so this is a bit of an answer here. I feel like this Five of Wands and the Five of Swords, like, I do feel like, all due respect, Sag, because, you know, I'm a Sag, so I'm saying this to myself too, that you might blame other people or you might blame yourself, okay, for things that go wrong, and you're not really looking at why things aren't progressing. And so the Knight of Pentacles and the Strength card are basically giving you the power and the courage and the nuts and bolts, one step at a time. Let's not skip over the fact that we're not really in alignment with what we're wanting to manifest. Why is that? Do I feel like I don't deserve it? Do I feel like I'm not worthy of it? Do I feel like other people always block my happiness? Do I feel like other people are to blame, that somebody, you know, when I'm manifesting, I want to manifest love and I get someone who doesn't want commitment, or that someone who's hurtful, that's always somebody else's fault. But you're manifesting based on your alignment. So let's start at the beginning, shall we? Let's start at the alignment instead of what shows up. Because we know what's going to show up. If we're out of alignment, if we're saying, I want chocolate pudding, and my alignment says, pizza, then, then it's sort of like wires are crossed, right? There's not really any kind of symmetry to what we're saying. And so if we're wanting the flavor of pizza and we get the chocolate pudding and we're like, nah, that's not what my heart really wanted, or that's not what I'm in alignment with. I'm in alignment with pizza. So pizza, chocolate pudding. So all we have to do is turn the dial. If we're wanting pizza, we have to turn the dial to pizza. It sounds simple, and it may be simpler than how you feel. But I also think that's part of the problem, is that you think it's not simple. It's not easy just to turn the dial to align with what you're wanting, because there's some kind of hidden ugly in here that says, I'm not worthy of this. Okay, the Knight of Cups and the Two of Cups. I do feel like there is a love partner that is destined and fated to come along for Sagittarius. And if you've been really frustrated with love for a while, maybe a year or two, maybe more, it's time to move away from what you used to do and try something new. Okay? Maybe try to even understand what's going on for you subconsciously. And how do we do that? If it's subconscious, we don't know about it. The way we know about it is our triggers. Those are things that we are believing subconsciously. So triggers usually happen. It's an outsized reaction to an experience. So if you, let's say, okay, this is kind of a interesting one, but if you see couples all around you, right? You're like, it's like Valentine's Day, and you're like, oh, Valentine's Day, it's such a Hallmark call. You know, it's such a Hallmark holiday. It's not a real holiday. Oh, look at those stupid people. Don't they know they're just going to get divorced? Oh my, right? Like having all this negativity, and then your friend's like, well, don't you want love? Oh yeah, I want love. But you're really believing that it's not going to work out. Okay. You're really believing it's not going to work out. So you're kind of fighting against yourself, and it's possible that at some point in your life, you may have been very vulnerable and somebody really took advantage of you. Because we Sagittariuses are known for this. This is our brand, that we are very optimistic, that we can kind of miss red flags sometimes. And what's being asked of us is really to do something different, to be more powerful and in charge of what we want to manifest, first of all. So we're getting rid of that noise, or we're getting rid of that, I want this, but really inside me, I don't believe in it, right? We're getting rid of that, and we're going to start putting one foot in front of the other and being courageous about stepping into what we want. And saying, yeah, I'm deserving of this. I'm worthy of this. And I want someone in my life. I want this experience. And, you know, some of us may move too quickly to try to get, you know, nail something down. Some of us may move in a direction and then we just get all of our triggers come up, all of our, the things we do to destroy relationships, the self-sabotage, all this kind of stuff. The victim mentality, whatever it is, it's really time to see all the constellation of things that are keeping you from happiness. What is keeping you from happiness? I feel like April is going to be a time for us to really recognize this so we can move forward. We can stop self-sabotaging ourselves. That's not all that easy to say. Let me ask one more thing. The Nine of Wands. All right, I had a flipper here. So the Queen of Cups, the Six of Cups, the Four of Swords, and the Star. Two healing cards. This is about healing your heart. What is the thing? Who broke your heart? And have you really looked at that? Can you look back and not be like a victim, like, oh, all these people, look at all my relationships and they all broke my heart. It's more of a, I'm going to say this is, you know, I love the Queen of Cups and everything, and that's beautiful. But this is Aquarian energy. And there is air energy, like thinking and seeing from a very kind of objective or dispassionate position. Right, we've got Libra and Taurus and the Empress, and we've got Gemini here, so all the air signs are here. So we can really kind of like, it's almost like us being a detective and kind of picking apart what is really keeping us from our greatest happiness, and then doing the work of healing it, having some self-compassion. And also knowing that it's going to be okay, right? That if we want something to come into our lives, that we're going to be able to attract it. And that we are not all the time attracting people who aren't what we want. Okay? All right. So I'm going to continue on with this Sagittarius. Let's see where we go. I feel like April is a turning point of this, where you really kind of align yourself with the thing that you want most. And then it can show up. Okay? So Saggies, the link is below. If you want to continue on with me, we'll see where we go from this point forward. Link is below. I'll see you over there. All right. I hope you enjoyed that video. If it was helpful to you, please consider liking this video and sharing it with anybody who might have a need for similar kind of information. And if you like this video, check out these videos.